So there I sat, the physician's eyes, is least hyperbole that I can put it, busting out of his sockets, jaw dropped, looks at me and says, "Wow, typically people who are this bad are on medication." Which, if you can't tell, isn't something you probably want to hear from a trained medical physician. So how did we get here? Why is a physician telling me I should probably be on drugs? Well, it all kind of starts with this. I low-key have a fear of television. Yeah, it's gonna get weird. Now, this would be the part of the video where I say, let me explain real quick. But, Vibi broke our computer last episode, so...
I broke the computer.
Look, I'm just looking at the only people in the room.
You are also in the room.
Ah, whatever.
And out of all the people standing in this room, who was the one acting all hysterical after getting a text?
Okay, too soon. You know what? Who bumped into who doesn't matter.
I think it does.
It doesn't. What matters is that this video is sponsored by the kind folks over at Verve, the premier place to watch your favorite shows, cartoons, and anime. Use my link in the description, verve.co/CurtRichy, to get a 30-day ad-free trial of Verve Premium. But we'll get more into that later when things work.
Also, why are you sponsored by an app for watching shows if you're talking about having a fear of watching shows?
Oh, Vibi, we'll get to that contradiction later, don't worry. For now, let me just tell you why I need drugs. So growing up, I was really into television, which is leagues away from being told to be on medication, so this is gonna be a fun video. TV took up the majority of my 9-year-old life. It was TV before school, TV after school, TV before bed. I was really into it. Like, I vividly remember, I was so into TV. My parents told me I used to take karate, but stopped because I, quote, didn't have enough time to watch TV. And I mean, to me, it really was a form of escapism. I just wanted to take a break from learning about lessons and morals and how to treat people and go home and watch something. Ironically enough, about lessons and morals about how to treat people, but this time with an aardvark. In fact, I'm pretty sure I maintained the same TV habits through my preteens and early teens. There are years when me watching Clifford the Big Red Dog overlapped with the years people were having sex in my grade. So I was really on it. See, the way I saw it, school was 8 hours in the day, right? Which more or less is pretty much the entire day. But I should have paid more attention in school. I'm exhausted pre-class, I'm exhausted post-class. Look, I'm just exhausted. Sitting and ignoring various people for 8 hours a day is exhausting. I needed that extra relaxation time, and you'd figure this would be fine because it's just a little time off. But the thing with watching TV is that it's a lot like French fries. You can't just consume one of them. You know, I tell myself I'll just watch one more episode. Yeah, just one more. I'd always find myself kind of trapped in this TV watching loop. And even if it wasn't TV, it was really about my relaxation time period. If I was playing video games, napping, even reading, what a time. I just keep doing that instead of working on whatever I was supposed to be doing. Really, it's just physics. An object watching Arthur or not doing stays wanting to watch Arthur and not doing shit. Isaac Newton said that specifically. But don't get me wrong now. I also didn't care. I like to think most sacks of shit don't. And that's mostly because, well, like, fuck school. And if I was gonna spend my entire day watching Word Girl, then I'm gonna spend my entire day watching motherfucking Word Girl. Get off my dick. But there's a slight problem with that. Aside from a grown man wanting to watch a child on television. Now, my house has always been all about work ethic. It just runs in the family. My great-grandpa, hard-ass. Grandpa, hard-ass. My pops, hard-ass. Me, soft-ass. The softest ass. Which I think caused some tension between me and my pop, because he didn't necessarily find me watching Word Girl every day the most productive thing. And he'd always get on me about it. You know, I'd be watching some Fetch with Ruff Ruffin, and he'd bust in the room saying, "Kurt, you need to stop lollygagging and work on your craft. You're gonna realize when you're not consecrating yourself to your work and you don't handle your business, it's gonna leave you with regrets." Now imagine that whole exchange, but like a lot blacker. That's what he said. And he hit me with something like this every day, but you know, it never really stuck. Like, sure, I guess you could say my first initial fear of TV started here, but it was more so because I didn't want to get yelled at every day. But as I got older and moved out the house, that fear kind of became real. And I remember it clear as day. It was earlier this year in college. I'd stayed in bed, like watching some anime or something for a bit. And I had a project to start. It was my honors thesis. I needed to finish it so I could graduate and be done with this hellhole. Basically, I had to write up a whole research paper and then edit and record a video about it. You know, whatever. I do this in my sleep, regular shit. But I was going to get to it later. For now, I was just enjoying the lazy weekend, you know, watching some anime. At least I thought I'd be enjoying a lazy weekend. Boy, what felt like a couple episodes in, I looked at the clock. I've been watching anime for like 8 hours. I've never felt panic roll in so fast. I ain't touched the project. It was due tomorrow. And this wasn't the project you could be as like procrastination. Oh, no, it's fine. Bet. Nah. This needed to be done today and there was no time left. I'm telling you, I couldn't finish it. We're talking thick with 2 C's honors finals thesis project where you have to like think and my body went into shock after that. I really was upset. Like it scarred me. Like D-Day, but for procrastination, school scarred me. And that's where it all started. Now, thankfully, I'm double incompetent.
It was only like the first of the 5 drafts due. So it was, yeah. Thank you. I'm not done with it.
But that thing stuck with me. Like PTSD, but for college. You ever have a parental lecture hit you, but not until 3 years later? And because of that, to this day, when I watch TV, I get a feeling of anxiety that starts to grow inside me. Because that time I'm watching TV, I could probably be working on assignment, chores, favors, working so I can, I don't know, live. Like, dog, do you know how scary it is to sit in a corner of your room for 9 hours, but not because of your seasonal depression? That's just wild to me. So now, as a working adult, I found the solution. Stop. Just completely stopped. Like, I try my best not to watch TV. Like, I changed my lifestyle completely. And honestly, I really stopped doing anything that kind of took away time from being productive. I was on a tight schedule for myself. Work, 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 then work, and then hit one more work just to be safe. And I'm not gonna lie, it felt pretty damn good. I don't know, like, there's a different feeling between laying down in your bed and knowing you have 80 things to do instead of laying down in your bed knowing you did 80 things. Like, I'd take the latter every time. At least I thought that. So I was getting my exit physical for track and field because that's a thing I do. And I was feeling pretty damn good. I was on my new lifestyle. That day was a great day, not gonna lie. I felt calm, not distressed whatsoever. That's really important that I was not distressed whatsoever. I did all my tests like usual and I'm doing fine. Then the physician pulls out the blood pressure checker or whatever you call it. And he put that thing around my arm, turned it on, and my blood pressure cranks out to 144 over 90. Now, if you're like me, that means nothing. There's numbers. I wasn't good in numbers in the first place, especially when there's like a little slant in between them. But that is bad. Like, for some perspective on this chart, I am in the red, where people recommend being on medication. And that's what he did. He said to me, people who are this stressed are typically on medication. You ever had someone tell you you should be on medication and not for being sad? As a joke. And it's not like I had some other lifestyle change since the last time I took the test, all right? Like, I eat and do all the same things. I'm still relatively the same piece of shit. The only thing that changed were my work habits. But someone saying I needed meds, I don't know, caused an instant shock to the system. I felt like every bone in my body started scraping each other. I didn't realize how tired I was till that exact moment and how much my body had been falling apart and what I'd actually been doing with myself. See, I think people really preach this thing of always bust your ass. And you should, you know, you should. But you also need to fucking rest too. And I feel like that's an obvious solution, but I don't think in practice it is. Because you get sucked into wanting to work and you get sucked into TV shows. So how do you fix that? See, for now, I've just been trying to work on my own schedule. When I take breaks and have time to work on my craft, I do that. But I also take the time to relax and watch some TV or anime or whatever, because it's equally as necessary. It's like when everyone's parents used to say, you shouldn't stay outside too long, but you shouldn't stay inside too long. I mean, it sounds weird, but they were right. It's a mix of the middle. You need both. That's something I didn't necessarily get as a kid or as an adult either. But knowing this is one thing and actually doing it is a whole other, because I realize the thing it takes to do both these things is discipline. More specifically, to stop doing these things. To stop being sucked in and just work, or stop being sucked into the show and just watch it. And sure, it hasn't been perfect for me. I've done it while working on this video plenty. But I think it's the right direction to go. So yes, sure, make sure you work and bust your ass, but also take the time to relax, watch some TV, and chill out.
You think this'll work?
No.
Well, this was the best I got, so...
All right, well, anyways, and my recommended way to use that relaxation and off time is with this video sponsor, Verve. Real talk, Verve has been my number one place to go watch anime, cartoons, and just overall dope content for a while now. I've been telling people about Verve and using it for about a year and a half or so, so trust me when I say it's big worth. Verve is the premier spot to watch an amazing selection of dope anime, cartoons, and shows all ad-free. And even if you find yourself lacking an internet connection sometimes, it's all Gucci because you can save episodes of your favorite shows to watch offline. And if you want to take advantage of this dope deal, don't worry, I got you. For a limited time, all you gotta do is click my link in the description below. That's verve.co/CurtRichy. I always wanted to say that. So you can get your very own 30-day free trial of Verve Premium. 30 days of free streaming content. Come on now. Which hooks you up with unlimited ad-free access to Crunchyroll, Rooster Teeth, a Cartoon Hangover, High Dive, and so much more. And you can access it with your Android, iOS, certain game consoles, and even Roku. We've got all your bases covered, my G. I've recently been religiously binging JoJo's Bizarre Adventure and Mob Psycho, which have been really fantastic so far, like to the point where I am like emotionally wrecked talking about it now. And in my Discord every Sunday-ish, we have a movie night and light binge a show on Verve. Last time we watched this Magical Girl anime that isn't a Magical Girl anime. Really, just check it out. Just get Verve, you know what I'm talking about, because that one really messed me up. Messed the whole server up. Typically, sorry guys, people tend to pirate shows when they do movie nights like that. But trust me, the connection is going to be super slow and it's going to take forever to load. And you'll be tired of the hentai god ads next to your show. Boy, when we streamed, we popped up Verve and it was so clean. And it gave me back control to see naked Japanese cartoons when I wanted to. And don't forget, if you want to get that juicy, not hentai god goodness, all you got to do is click my link in the description. That's verve.co/CurtRichy to get a 30-day ad-free trial of Verve Premium. Oh, what's up, y'all? Oh, there's another one in the books. Thank you guys for watching. So if you liked that video, which I hope you did, I really suggest checking out the very questionably named Why Stalking is Actually Natural video. Very similar to this one. I think you'll have a really good time if you're into more questionable me decisions. That's about it. Thank you guys for watching. As per usual, I don't really got much else to say. Just come kick it with me in the Discord server. Link in the description to that also below. Well, that's about it. I'm Adi. Talk to you guys. Peace out.